retracted, it's fixed it down. The propeller doesn't have to be adjusted. There goes the first of our airplanes, the Fairchild PT-23. In 1942 vintage. It has a round radial engine. Lifting off right behind. Small queen at PT-23, I believe it's probably parked the nest, isn't it? PT-19. All these airplanes made by Fairchild, starting about 1941, 42, range. Powered by various engines, and that would determine what the designation of the airplane was.
PT-17 or PT-13.
with the civil air patrol.
Stop now.
take a look at this airplane and notice that it has swept back away. You'll see another example of that vintage of aircraft with swept wings. Gives a little more speed, but that particular airplane, the Stampe SV-4, is a wonderful aerobatic performing airplane. It was used in aerobatic competitions. Rothmans Tobacco Company in the UK sponsored the Rothmans aerobatic team back in the 50s and 60s. Pilots were flying these very, very capable aerobatic Stampe SV-4. Former world champion named Neil Williams, British pilot, flew those airplanes. Now, you see that they're landing, they're parallel to that runway 18. Here comes one from the left landing on it. The other ones are going in the other direction and parallel to that runway. That's because these, at airports, we have kind of racetrack-shaped traffic pattern. And the normal entry is to enter the downwind, which is parallel to the landing runway, but in the opposite direction. And then you make a 90-degree left-hand turn as you look at the runway, and that's the base turn, and then you turn, lined up on the runway on final approach, and come on in and land. And again, 180 on the compass, 180 on the runway. Landing on runway 18, which is the direction into the wind. I spent my whole life flying airplanes. About 40 years.
Where you going, Mark?
It's very rare that you actually land into the wind because it's always blown across the runway somehow. And the airports use a different runway to get for traffic reasons or noise reasons. So the wind is usually not blowing down the runway if there is any wind. And I remember as a flight engineer of the 707 years ago, there was a captain who was going to be retiring. He had like 27,000 hours of flying. And I asked him, I said, is there anything you want to do in aviation before you retire? And he thought for a minute, he turned around, he said, you know, son, there is. He said, before I retire, I'd like to land into the wind. Just once, I'd like to land into the wind. But it never happens. Except today here in Reading, where we're landing on runway 18. According to the SOC, that's the direction it's coming from. Coming from the SOC. Here you can see the radial engine configuration on Paul Quinn's cylinder PT-23. And our primary trainers are... touching down and taxiing back, turning off here at the... Actually, they've landed on the other runway. They make a right turn onto the main runway. And they're coming back to land. Civil Air Patrol aircraft touching down. And in just a moment. We'll have our advanced trainers take to the runway. Primary trainers, fixed landing gear. That makes sense, but on the next airplanes that you're going to see that have variable pitch propellers, you can increase the power to the engine, but the propeller blades change pitch, the way they attack the air. So you add power, the engine's stronger, but it may not go any faster because you want a more efficient propeller to drive it through the air. Okay, here comes our Fairchild 24. That airplane will show you where the Civil Air Patrol display is set up. I urge you to consider the award of that Congressional Gold Medal. And if you know of anyone who served in Civil Air Patrol during World War II, they may be eligible, and probably are eligible, to receive the Congressional Gold Medal. So please tell your friends who had participated in the Civil Air Patrol in World War II, and tell them, and these people will tell you how to get in touch with the Civil Air Patrol to turn in their names and make sure that they receive their copy of that wonderful award just presented, just signed into law on May 23rd. Wonderful stories about the Fairchild, Sherman Fairchild, who was born just before 1900. Bright, indulged child, grew up in a world of wealth and comfort, but he just wasn't sitting around spending daddy's money. Very, very clever design. Developed Fairchild aerial cameras for the U.S. Army. Building and designing these aircraft, for example. Oh, where did the money come from? Well, his dad had a tabulating machine company that kind of got large and interested other investors, and the eventual company became known as IBM. So they did pretty well with that. Here comes a P-24 to take off rolls. Interestingly enough, those radial engines on board.
You better shout.